With all the issues hounding the agriculture sector, a former top economist of the Philippine government says it's about time for President Marcos to appoint a full-time agriculture secretary. Former NEDA Chief Ernesto Pernia says the agriculture sector needs the full attention of the department's head.
From the beginning, a good agriculture secretary should have been in place. The president's hands are full. And, you know, we have this agriculture problem, which is a huge problem. So, you know, it makes sense to have a good agriculture secretary, a good manager, not necessarily an expert in, you know, agricultural products, but a good manager, a good, you know, overseer of what's happening in the agriculture sector. Because our agriculture sector has been really been, you know, just lagging behind the other sectors, as well as compared with our Asian neighbors' agriculture sectors.
Marcos earlier said he took the portfolio as DA secretary to make it clear he will prioritize the agriculture sector and urgently address rising food prices. Now, here's another possible headache for consumers. After sugar and salt, the Philippine Agriculture Department now warns local farm output of garlic will not be enough to meet demand for the rest of the year. Vivian Gulia has more.
Demand for garlic in the Philippines for the second half of 2022 is projected to hit over 73,000 metric tons. That's based on the outlook the Department of Agriculture Bureau of Plant Industry presented before the House Committee on Agriculture and Food during Tuesday's briefing. But it expects the country's garlic supply for that period to only be at nearly 37,000 metric tons, just a little over half of the projected demand, and all of it will be imported. Data from the Bureau show that the Philippines only managed to produce less than 5,000 metric tons of garlic for the year, harvested within the first half. This is why lawmakers are pushing to support local garlic farming to revitalize domestic production.
We are not sufficient at all pagdating po sa garlic, sir. No, we are dependent on importation. Its insufficiency, admittedly, is a problem that we've been facing, and improvement in production yield and the quality of our garlic is also something that we have to work on.
Dati pag pupunta ako sa Manawag, you can see the local garlic that we can buy. It's now wala na. It's a dead industry. This is a high-value crop that must be fully supported and its local production further increased so we can meet our own local consumption.
Even the Philippines' remaining supply of white onions is scarce, according to DABPI. The Bureau said its monitoring as of last August 24th showed no more stocks of yellow granix or white onions in the Ilocos region, Central Luzon, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, Central Visayas, Northern Mindanao, Davao region, and Metro Manila.
From the time that it was last imported from January, we expected that demand will be last only 5 months. That's why at this time po, the supply of yellow onion is zero or scarce.
The DA said it plans to put up additional cold storage facilities in strategic locations to help increase the shelf life of locally harvested onions. The agency is also looking into addressing onion farmers' appeal for assistance on fertilizers and other agricultural inputs.
Post-harvest facilities are being looked into, agricultural inputs as well. As far as budget allocations is concerned, we will sit down with a high-value crop and we will see if there are other programs like agribusiness and marketing also, so we can complement whatever one program lacks.
The DA also looking at salt supply. The agency notes locally produced salt is insufficient to meet the demand. Officials say there is a need to identify areas for salt production and improve the technology used by producers. As for rice, the Department of Agriculture is not expecting any shortage for 2022, but noted that soaring fertilizer prices is affecting local production. The Philippines has allocated a funding of 3.3 billion pesos for fertilizer support to rice farmers in the form of discount vouchers for 2022. This figure is proposed to increase to 19.5 billion pesos next year. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.